Hey guys, this is going to be my first video for Generation Zero. I've been playing it for a little while. Haven't done any videos on it. But let's just jump in. My plan today is to work on some of the new content. We're going to be doing the quest in the top left, making friends. I'm gonna investigate that beach, that bunker, and that pier. These are like dailies you can do. Basically, you can have like daily and weekly things that you can do. You gain points and materials and such. We are over here. Some of the stuff out of our inventory. Alright. I'll need that. I'll need that. Do you need that? I don't need that. Those. This is basically my sniper rifle, my up close SMG, and my bazooka. I don't have any handguns. I do have a decent handgun, but it's just I don't have the ammo for it right now. I think I've got a good assortment of ammo for those. Do not need these. Put some of these away. I don't need landmines. Don't need repair kits. Everything else is being used. Those are basically, like it says, attachments here. So these are all attached to my weapons right now. Yep, as you can see, and then I have thermal. Also got an X-ray option, so I can like, see through walls. But I can't do that inside the bunker here, so let me show you that. Alright, so, let's take a look at our map. From where we are, so this outline here is basically the starting area, and then you can move into this area. I've moved into this area a little bit, but as you can see, it's quite a large map. It doesn't look big, but trust me, it feels big. But it looks like, okay, we're going to be going here, to the pier, looks like this bunker, and, over here. I can fast travel to these little safe houses, but not the individual places. I guess we'll go ahead, I mean, it doesn't really seem to matter. I guess we could do them in order. What's this one? Yeah, I guess we'll go to that one first. It would be closer to go to this, I suppose. Yeah. Do that. Let's go ahead. Jump over here. The premise of this game is a mysterious robot force has taken over, and you are, well, basically you and your quote-unquote friends, as this is a multiplayer, we're basically on vacation. And so, you managed to avoid being captured as apparently everyone else has been captured. You are the resistance now, essentially. Nice. Want to keep a few of those on you because basically, if you have all your hit points taken away, then that is what's going to bring you back. You're able to use an adrenaline shot to basically get back on your feet. Otherwise, yeah, I respawn back to your last autosave, which is typically in these safe houses. You'll occasionally see a little icon in the top right. That is the save. Now let's go ahead and put this stuff away that I just picked up. Something like okay, and because I put that away. I'm not gonna have to back into my inventory. And okay, you have to make sure the ammo goes back in because sometimes the ammo does not go back in. I won't let me put it on there. That's fine. Don't honestly need it. It would have been handy, but it's not. You have to be careful. Things like that are ambush points. They have pretty large robots patrolling the area. Well, I say large. And they're bigger than me, but they're just like medium robots. Oh. Okay, so that's basically a little scout that flies around, and if it detects you, it sets off an alarm. Go ahead and set up the. Okay, I'm gonna do that right now. I can get myself a bicycle if I want. I think I'm going to. I think I'm going to walk. It's not that far, and I feel like it'll be advantageous. Okay. Keep an eye on what's going on. Essentially, like I said, everybody in this game has been... Well, you're not sure. Okay, so they've all disappeared. You have met up with a girl who thinks that they've all been kidnapped and taken to a rendezvous point that basically everyone originally agreed on, and then now they're being held there. But you're not sure. Well, that's kind of the whole point of the game, is to try and figure out what happened to everyone else. It is very much a survival game, just as much as it's a shooter game. You're not really building bases. There's a little bit of a base building element, but it's very on rails. You're not going to have a lot of freedom when it comes to base building. But there is an extensive crafting system. A lot of options as far as weapons and things of that nature. Probably actually switch to the thermal since it's nighttime. Basically going up and over this mountain here. Probably get on the other side of the coast. Yeah, clicking noises. Basically, ticks are just tiny robots that jump at you. They're usually guarding little campsites like this. Alright. Or something else. Something much bigger. And just supplies. I can get a bicycle, but apparently I can't ride other people's bicycles, which never really made sense to me. I'm hearing much larger robots. Yeah. at this room. See what we run into. Right in front of us. It's a runner. Awesome. Oh, there's another runner. I could easily take those out. I don't really need to. But it would be better if they would clump up. That one. I'm dealing with it. The other was two. Yeah, he's throwing it back. Maybe we can get him side by side. I've actually taken both out with one shot, because they tend to explode. Oh, is it over here? Is it here? Okay, he's headed back. May come to check me out. Oh. This game is a lot like Skyrim in that Delph is your friend, whereas the Stealth Archer is the OP Skyrim player. The sniper in this one is the OP, far as I'm concerned. Like I said, I can take both of these out in one shot if they just get close enough together. There's one, then we go. I don't know if they're both over there. I think we're just gonna turn out things that stops moving. And we'll wait for the heat to die down, we're gonna take out the other one. Off. Those things aren't super dangerous, I could actually probably take them out melee, no problem. But where there are small robots, there are big robots. I'm guessing right here. Dealing with maybe a small pack. Runners tend to move in packs like that. Usually more than two. I've seen as many as like six or eight. And they have a very wide patrol. They'll patrol all over the place. But we're just going to avoid them for now. I know for a fact that this area over here is patrolled. We'll have to be careful. And I know that up there, it's some sort of like old castle rooms or the visitor center or something where they set up a base of operations. So there's about 10 of those runners up there where they can hang out. Fall damage in this game is kind of ridiculous. I mean, you can literally fall like 10 feet and die. It's crazy. But if you're careful, you can slide. Leading where we need to go. I don't know that there's like an illness system in this game, but you definitely don't want to be wet. Like, I know that there is a viable aspect. These are binoculars. Machine gun, huh? Yeah, he's not too bad. Zone's got like a rocket launcher. Did I hear something big? That dark canister on his back right there is what I'm going to be aiming for. It's basically his fuel cell. One hit blows the whole thing up, and if the other one's close enough, it'll blow him up too. And I kind of need them to get close together. Alright, buddy, come on back. Are you supposed to stand there? Okay, so you're just gonna patrol over there. That's fine. We'll take you out. And... oh, I missed. Uh-oh, there's another one. Get wise. Oh, he's coming up here. I have to take him out. Yeah, let's go take him out. He's too curious. Now, if I just chill here for a minute, it'd be fine. His buddy should come investigate, and we'll get him. Yeah, oh. Spotted him. Here he comes. He'll come investigate. And scan him, and when he scans him, I'll shoot you. For half a second. Of course. I don't see anybody else down there, so we're going to meet now. Might be something here. That's a campsite. Get hornets here. Previous quest, but I think these things are not. This one. That is from a previous quest. I won't spoil it for you if you want to take it in. It's better this one. Some new ones show up because I took the core. Yeah, I took your precious data core or whatever. Okay, see how much I'm standing there? Find him quick, sun's coming up. He's gonna find me. Probably up there on the red rocks. Go ahead and loot this one. Never understood why the robot's curious. First aid packs, but not complaining. No way in hell I'm getting back up there, so I'm gonna have to go the other way, which is the long way around. If you look at the map, there is a path, but I gotta get over here. Going the long way down, or probably way too close to fast travel. But oh, he's still looking for me. Go ahead and fast travel to our next destination. Where are we going? There's one. That looks like we're going to the safe house. Okay, that was weird. Alright, interesting, since I still have a weapon and collectible to find here. I thought those robots were big. Wait till you see the stuff hanging out outside here. If it was. But it's probably about the size of a large earth mover, I had to guess. If we can't. Big robots. Baseball bat. There's a second weapon. Possibly. Probably in one of the buildings, obviously. Oh. Little medium sized robot. Well, upright on two legs. Fast, but they're really not anything to be super worried about. Look at that. This. The only reason I'm using the simple first aid kit, it doesn't actually heal that much, but I have a lot of them. I use them up. can't like recycle and repurpose them for anything really. So kind of a pain, but I mean, I guess I could recycle them, but all you get is cloth and much better as a healing item. So be a truck out here. Is it over here? Over here. Yep, here's my weapon. That's it. Looking at, yep. Try another shot. Okay, took out a couple. There you go. Take it out. It's amazing to me. Games like this have always made me laugh. That, you know, we'll find dozens of, you know, army corpses laying around, and, you know, all these, dead people that, you know, fought these things and didn't make it, and yet, here I am, by myself, and I guarantee you I've killed a lot more than they ever did. So, one thing you shouldn't really concern yourself, unless it's your first playthrough, got a voice box, nice. Unless it's your first playthrough and you really don't have any equipment or anything, you don't need to loot everything like I am. Once you have a pretty substantial stash coin, you can, you don't have to worry about checking every vehicle. I am a bit of a hoarder. A lot of survival game players are. And I like to take everything. I pick up all the things. As far as I'm concerned, you never know when you're going to need them. And it's better to have them, not need them, than to need them and not have them. Now, does that mean I have to make several trips back to the stash to unload my inventory? Yeah, absolutely. But, there, enough looting cars. Let's head for our mission. It's 700 meters. Alright, we're going to... I'm gonna walk. Don't like the sounds of these robots. Now, you know, I say don't worry about looting everything, but if you want the all of the clothes and, you know, cosmetic items and whatnot, you're gonna have to loot everything. They are random. They can be in any and all containers. There's the vehicle site. Alright, oh, got some stuff there. I mean, saw me get that jacket over there, just got another jacket here. Apparently the new companions are gonna have different voice boxes you can use. I've already got two of them. It'd be interesting. Let's walk. We're gonna go down the main road. We're gonna try to stay out of sight. We're gonna stay off to the side. And we're definitely gonna encounter some big robots. Get to see some of the stuff you're actually fighting. Stuff you've seen so far is nothing. Nothing compared to what you're fighting. I mean, imagine taking on a tank with a pitchfork. I've done that. Okay, hear that? There's several. Also, here's a room. They're not too hard. They're fast. They're not too hard. Again, they have the power cell in the back, but it's a little more protected, as you can see. You can shoot the weapon off their arms so that they can't shoot you. But at that point, they just come at you with a giant fucking blade. It's ridiculous. And it looks like we got about three of them over there. They're not too bright, though. But didn't have any problems avoiding them. I don't like the sound of that other. Sounds like we got a pretty big robot. And actually, they just go ahead. Yeah. We can get back to the shed. I'm gonna take one of these out. Hopefully lure the other ones. And take them out pretty easy. for it. Yeah. You wander off. You get stuck somewhere? Oh yeah, he's right here. Have a gas mask, so it reduces the amount of damage it does. If you do not have a gas mask, I do not recommend hanging out in it too long. Using his little yellow scanning to scan through walls. Here we go. Like we attracted the other one, so. Huh? Oh, let me loot him. There we are. No early access. I hear walking around over here. Oh. Oh, we only pulled one. I guess that other one was something else. Alright, well. Give me a clean shot. Give me a clean shot. Clean shot. Gun's in the way. By the way, it's not dark all the time, but it is cloudy and rainy a lot. And again, I am wearing a gas mask. That's why you can kind of see a vignette around the screen. Oh, one of them's on me. By the way, that bullet will seriously fuck you up. Oh, there you are. There's another one. Him at all. Oh, Honestly, I got hit once. Maybe twice. That hurts. Stuck out there? Definitely hear it much larger. Got lots of runners up here, look at that. Basically surrounded right now. But there's not one right here. Okay, good. Find this now. Get him out. Jacob out there. I should turn the lights off in here. It's the light switch. Great, but if you got nothing else, it something. They're investigating right now because they're not sure why their fridge is blew up. There's one. There's a bunch of them out there. Another big one. The missiles immediately. He thinks he got me. There he is. for help.
Thank you.
it took so long. Alright, so that basically means that a new legendary bot was created because I have increased challenge rating of the area by killing these big robots. So the more of these things you kill without dying, basically the harder the game gets because it's adjusting to your skill level, essentially. So if you do like I do and hide in buildings and snipe them continuously, it gets harder and harder and harder. And the more legendaries go up. That's, if you look at the map, what all these flashing orange things are, they're legendary robots. They have really good loot. So they can either, basically they'll either level up or a new one will pop up every time that message pops up. Is there anything out here? Oh, that's some more high explosive rounds, that's good. We're out. Cooked. Alright. But you cleared the area, I'm pretty sure. Let's head on down to our quest objective, and I think we're gonna call it for this video. It's already been an hour and a half, long one. And I feel like we got a good, good first video going. Unfortunately, there's a lot of those little areas where you get stuck and put all the kinks out on the hitboxes. You have to be careful going into tight spaces like that. Again, I have a gas mask on. You wouldn't want to be walking around in all this smoke without the gas mask. Here. gonna get caught up looting. I'll just do that later. Careful on these paths though. The runners, they like to use them for patrols. Police vehicles. Their lights and sirens. Oh, well, not sirens, but their lights on still. Candy box. Doesn't mean they're not there. Destination over there, I think. There are flying bots. I don't think there's any in this area. Like I said, this is kind of the beginning area. Looks like that would be unfair. Oh, there's a big one. Feels like it would be a bit unfair to have flying bots in the beginning area. But there are flying bots, so if you ever hear a weird noise, look up. Got some runners. Get me. little armor pad under here. I love when they duck just as good. Neat trick there to get that thing out on fire. Fire's key, huh? Okay. I'm gonna find some keys here. Encumbered. currently have a key. Can we get inside? Maybe? The door? What? I like the rules for encumbrance in this game. You can become encumbered. It gradually slows you down until you can't move. So it's not like, oh, I have 200 pounds, I can't move. It becomes a struggle to stay up. Nice. Even if you are encumbered, you are able to make your way back to a base. You can't fast travel from the cupboard, so you do have to find a recycling bench to break things down if you want to fast travel. But otherwise, 100% possible to carry a bunch of stuff. Recycling bench, hopefully. You can also drop loot and it will stay there. At least for a little while. I'm not sure exactly how long it stays. I've never had it destroy me. Perhaps it is not infinite. Better set it up. There is no swim system. If you jump in the water, you just immediately pop back up on land nearby. At least you don't die, I guess. Okay. Came to do. Check him. Can you look up? Okay. Ooh, got some sort of hard drive or something. Cool. Alright, guys. Call it. Been a little over almost 2 hours now, so I think I'm gonna look around maybe a little bit more, see if I can find a recycling bench here or nearby, and probably head back to my base, or at least a nearby base. Actually, let's see. There's a safe house right there. Oh, we're just gonna run around over here. Safe houses have workbenches, recycling, stuff like that, and they also will have a storage chest, which, if nothing else, I can just put stuff in, and then this will place that has a workbench and break it all down, or recycle it, or whatever. Collectible. Nice. I like the new collectibles. There are old collectibles, but I do like the new ones. We got a storage chest. What else? Recycling bench outside, maybe? Over there, perhaps? In the shed. Vehicle bench. Help. Uh-oh. Company. This guy held out here. That thing apart, looks like it's bare hands. Lots of flares, that'll come in handy. You love my distractions. Alright. The silencer. Good. Let's see what's out here. Sounds like a walker. Be a walker and runners. Nobody's attention. I should be at the house. In the house. I've run into several instances where there's runners stuck in houses. That should be humorous. It might. Oh, I guess there is a runner up in here. Bigger, who knows? Got a radio here. Alright. I mean, if it's bigger than a runner stuck in that room, I would be shocked. But it does sound like a walker. Up through the roof. Oh. Whatever it is, it's stuck in there. Guess let's go find out. Can't open that door. Oh, there's one. Robot is wonderful. It'd be nice if you could get in there. Stuff. Almost get there. Oh, well. One runner's loot is not worth the trouble. So, we're gonna head back over here to the barn. I'll end up probably checking these vehicles later. I get motorcycles and I get bicycles. Well, dirt bikes. Dirt bikes obviously need gasoline and they're loud. Bicycles are a bit hard to control, but quiet. They do not alert robots when you're nearby. I actually rode right behind a robot just 10 feet off of them. And just goes right by. No problem. So, anyway, I think this is a good place to call it. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I know I did. If you enjoyed watching me play Gen Zero, I may set it up on Twitch. For now, though, I think I'm just going to record some instances and see what happens. Appreciate it if you do watch. If you watched this whole 2 hour video, then good on you, because I don't know that I would have. But I appreciate it. So like, comment, subscribe, whatever. And see you next time. Thanks, guys.